Olivier Brousse, the current global crisis leads us to question the purpose and relevance of our work. What is it at Veolia today?
Well, at Veolia, we really believe that what we do is useful. And being useful is really at the heart of our company, our business, and what our people do first thing in the morning. This is not new. Our CEO, Antoine Frérot, has said now for several years that he strongly believes that Veolia is profitable because it is useful and not useful because it is profitable. And this is really something fundamental for us. It's the heart not only of what we do in our different divisions, but it's also at the heart of our strategic plan, which is called Impact 2023. Of course, today we're in the middle of this healthcare crisis with COVID-19. And I think everybody is aware that sanitary matters are tightly linked to the environmental one, especially in terms of biodiversity and how, you know, we interact with nature. Well, as it happens, everything Veolia does in terms of distributing drinking water, in terms of treating wastewater, waste in general, or in the energy sector or air quality, everything we do is useful not only to the planet, but also to the healthcare system. So at Veolia for several years now, we've said that our prosperity in the long term would be ensured only by achieving a balance of performance between our different stakeholders. Of course, our shareholders are a very important stakeholder for Veolia, and we want to serve them well. But we will only be able to serve them well in the long term if we serve the other stakeholders, including the planet, you know, society at large, our employees.
The issue is that there are many companies whose core business is not, like you, intrinsically oriented towards environmentally friendly alternatives. So assuming that we eliminate some of these environmentally harmful activities, how can we save all the workers linked to the old world mentality that are now seriously threatened?
This is a key point. This is a key challenge, and it's not an easy one. And I'm glad you asked the question because, you know, we strongly believe that we can't just stop or get rid of the old activities just because they create pollution or carbon emissions. It's not about getting rid of them. It's about investing in their transformation and make them greener and cleaner. And, you know, the environment will not win at the expense of the social fabric, the social balance, and the workers. We've got to bring everybody along with us. If I take Veolia, for instance, you know, we're highly focused on the reduction of greenhouse emissions. And, you know, we're trying to do it for ourselves, of course, our own emissions, but also helping our clients, public authorities, cities, but also industrial clients, to reduce theirs. And again, we're trying to invent new models, new economic models, that will allow them to transform their activity, to clean their act, if I may say, without social casualties, because this will not work. So there should be no losers, otherwise nobody will win.
One of the characteristics of Veolia is that the company can count on an independent committee called Critical Friends that advise it on social and environmental issues. How can this committee support you in an ecological transition and in the management of the crisis we are going through?
Having a forum of experts, such as the Critical Friends, which have been in place, you know, for a couple of years since 2013, made of, you know, some of the best experts from NGOs, from, you know, non-profit organizations, who feel free to express solutions, criticism at times, to, you know, the highest level of the leadership of Veolia, is very important because it forces us to, you know, look in the mirror, to try to, you know, be better every day. And in the end, it's only this high level of demand that will allow us to stay as a benchmark and to stay as a credible benchmark in terms of ecological transition.